Christoph. I'm the project lead of the Hound, an experimental rocket which is designed to break the European altitude record.
My name is Andreas Bauernfand, and today with Christoph we would like to inform you about the improvements and changes of the rocket, the Hound.
The Hound was already launched last year here in the Black Rock Desert in Nevada. Unfortunately, the upper stage did not ignite successfully, which was basically due to miswiring of a safety device. Shortly after that, we decided that we would give it a next try. The next try is now this year.
And this year, we would like to launch two rockets to increase our chances of success. As you probably heard, last year we could successfully recover both parts of the rocket, so this year we have to manufacture only one additional rocket. The first change is probably the most visible. We decided to remove the white paint and the sponsor logos from the rocket. After the recovery, we have seen that some of the sponsor logos have been partly or fully removed due to the high velocity, and the surface was very rough and sticky. This year, we use a transparent foil that could be removed before the rocket launch. The second change is the airframe. Last year we have used Cyanat Ester for the sustainer. This year we have decided to use this material for both stages. We have also made some material analyze and figured out that we came pretty close to the specification in the datasheet. If you would like to read the report, check out our website. The third change is the head and ignition. With the new design, we are able to screw the igniter into the solid rocket motor later in the procedure. This year we are going to use boron potassium nitrate to ignite the engine. During the summer we have made successful vacuum chamber tests, so fingers crossed that this year we can ignite the upper stage.
So this is enough on the mechanical changes, and we now come to the avionics systems. As I already mentioned in the beginning, the upper stage of the Hound last year did not ignite because of a malfunction of a safety device. This safety device, we call it SDARM, so the Space Team Arming Device, should inhibit the ignition of the upper stage if people are around the rocket at the launch pad, for example during the launch procedure. This year we changed the design that we can include this device into our avionics stack, so we can get the status and see if it's working properly before we launch. Another major change is the radio system. So last year we learned that the radio modules are not working reliable. So we used the same LoRa modules, but we improved the PCB design and we also improved the antennas. So inside the rocket we now use self-built monopole antennas with a ground plane, and at the ground stations we use QFH antennas. We successfully tested this setup in Austria from one mountaintop to another mountaintop with 50 kilometers distance. So we are very confident that we have coverage during the whole mission in the desert. As a secondary RF link, we use an Iridium module, which transmits housekeeping and position data via an independent satellite communication network. This system was tested in a different project, where it flew on an experiment with a suborbital rocket up to 80 kilometers in Sweden last year. The last hardware change I want to mention is that we used different camera like last year. So the new camera is used in drones, so it is built for work in harsh environments with high vibration loads. For redundancy reason, we use two of these cameras per stage.
Thank you for your attention. We will keep you updated on our social media channels and the website. And if you have any further questions, please comment below.
Thanks, and we'll see you in space.